CataractCoach.com, we have an analysis of a 60th cataract surgery performed by a resident surgeon in training. So what's good here and what needs improvement? We're starting off the case here. This is a paracentesis that's already been made, filling the anterior chamber with viscoelastic. I like that backfill. That's done well. The paracentesis looks like it's a little bit long, though, so the angle of that should be changed to be a little bit shorter. Now, fixating the eye with forceps, and here's the keratome entering the eye, and now using the keratome to widen the incision. Now, this is kind of inexact, and it's probably a better move to use an appropriately sized keratome instead of just sawing the incision wider. But it looks still reasonable. Now, here the resident is using a forceps or needle holder to band his own cystotome. I like that idea. Now, you can see the cystotome is on a viscoelastic syringe. That's helpful. I like the idea. Poking in the center and starting the rexus here. And that looks really good. Floating in the incision, completing the capsular rexus here with just the cystotome. Now, this is a good thing to practice because it really helps you build that hand-eye coordination. If you dig too deeply with this, of course, you'll damage the flap or go into the cortex. You have to get it just right in order to make this rexus work with just a cystotome. And so I like the idea that the resident's doing it this way. Doing it with the forceps is actually a little bit easier, so doing it this way in the training is helpful. And you can see there more viscoelastic was injected to help keep the anterior chamber inflated. And that looks great. You'll see the three Purkinje images, three lights on the surface of the cornea. That's the first Purkinje image. And the eye staying in primary. Here's a J-shaped cannula for hydrodissection. Good fluid wave there. Another fluid wave. Notice how we also lose viscoelastic from the eye. And we'll go the other direction as well. And this looks pretty good. Nucleus is partially prolapsed out of the capsular bag. Remind you that this video is shown at 1.5 times speed, just so we can get through the whole video in a reasonable amount of time. Phaco tips going inside the eye looks like a smaller sleeve, maybe a 2.2 or 2.4 millimeter, and a spatula in the second hand. And the nucleus technique is, looks like it's going to be the tilt and tumble technique popularized by Dr. Lindstrom. And so there's not going to be any division of the nucleus here, just using the phaco probe to eat away at the nucleus. So it's been tilted out of the capsular bag and now tumbled, meaning it's pushed towards the probe. So there is no nucleofractus technique done here. For a softer lens like this, this is perhaps 2+ nuclear sclerosis. This is a very good technique and it works quite well. And so the goal here is just to keep the phaco tip occluded with lens material and then apply a mild degree of phaco energy and use, of course, vacuum and the fluidics to wolf down the cataract pieces. And it comes down pretty easily. So that technique worked very well. I'd encourage the resident, though, to learn a good nucleofractus technique. Stop and chop is good, or phaco, a variation of phaco chop is an important thing to learn because when you have a denser nucleus, this tilt and tumble technique is not ideal. But for a soft lens like this, it works beautifully. So now it's time for cortex removal. Looking at the draping of the lashes, it's pretty good. Looks like the on the left side, the superior lashes are draped well. This looks like a right eye with a temporal incision. The inferior lashes are a little bit exposed, and of course, that's not too bad, but that could be worked on for the future. Now removing lens cortex using the IA probe, I would adjust the IA sleeve so that it's further down the tip. Right now, the infusion ports are too far away from the aspiration. So when the surgeon pulls backwards to try to get the subincisional cortex, you have a danger, like there, of having infusion exit the eye. So maybe adjust that sleeve next time to have that in a better position. Cleaning up the capsular bag quite nicely. A little bit of capsular polishing going on here. And that looks pretty good. And then now, let's take a look around. Let's see the incisions. The main incision looks pretty good. Maybe a tad on the short side, but I'll take it. The paracentesis, of course, I think is a little bit too long and has some edema there. Filling the capsular bag now with a viscoelastic, looks like a cohesive viscoelastic. You can see that's a beautiful capsular rexus, so nicely done there. That should overlap the optic just about perfectly. That's probably about 5 to 5.5 millimeters. Here comes the IOL with the injector going inside the eye. And nice, good delivery. And so it appears that someone else has loaded the lens because there's no break in the video, which is certainly appropriate. Once you've mastered the loading of the lens yourself, certainly that task can be delegated to your scrub tech. At the beginning, though, in your first few dozen cases, I encourage you to load the lens yourself. You need to be able to set up the machine, load the lens, do every step of the procedure by yourself. What if one day your technician's not there? You need to be able to continue. There you see the overlap is quite good. Very nice. Removing viscoelastic here, and then just tilting the lens in various areas to get all the viscoelastic set out. Later on, as this resin gets better, we're going to go behind the eye wall to remove viscoelastic from behind the optic. That'll be important, let's say, for a toric lens to help keep it in good position. And then finally, let's hydrate the incision. So a little bit of hydration each direction. That incision actually looks great. So despite the sawing technique, which I'm not a big fan of, the incision looks like it's well-constructed and is sealing quite nicely. And again, that paracentesis looks a little bit on the long side. So overall, this is an excellent case. This resident is doing great. For having done only 60 cataracts under his belt, amazing. Very happy with this performance. So take-home message here, make sure the resident learns a good nucleofractus technique. Aim to learn phaco chop in the next 50 or 100 cases. And then here's a Wexel sponge to check the incisions. And those look good. And thanks for watching.